हेलो स्टूडेंट्स,
टुडे अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द सेम बुक एनसीईआरटी, द थर्ड चैप्टर द शेपर्ड्स ट्रेजर। इन अ विलेज इन ईरान देयर वंस लिव्ड अ शेपर्ड। ही वाज वेरी पुअर। ही डिड नॉट हैड इवन अ स्मॉल कॉटेज ऑफ हिज ओन। ही हैड नेवर बीन टू स्कूल और लर्न टू रीड एंड राइट, फॉर देयर वर वेरी फ्यू स्कूल्स इन दोज डेज। दो पुअर एंड अनएजुकेटेड, This shepherd was very wise. He understood people's sorrows and troubles and helped them face their problems with courage and common sense. Many people came to him for advice. Soon he became famous for his wisdom and friendly nature. The king of that country heard about him and thought of meeting him. Disguised as a shepherd and riding on a mule, one day the king came to the cave where the wise shepherd lived. Now, this story is about a shepherd who was living in Iran, and he was very poor and uneducated, and he did not had a cottage for himself. But the quality of this shepherd was that though he was uneducated, he was very good person. He had a lot of qualities a person should have. That type of qualities he had. Now, as soon as the shepherd saw the travelers coming towards the cave, he rose to welcome him. He took the tired traveler inside the cave, gave him water to drink and a share of his own merge meal. The king rested for the night in the cave and was greatly impressed by the shepherd's hospitality and wise conversation. Now, the king who came to meet this shepherd in disguise, he thought that he was only a shepherd. And when this shepherd, the king actually, when he came near the cave, the shepherd thought to give him some food and rest. Though still tired, the king decided to depart the next morning. He said, "Many thanks for your kindness to a poor traveler. I have a long way to go. Permit me to leave." Looking straight into the eyes of his guest, the shepherd replied, "Thank you, Your Majesty, for paying me the compliment of a visit." The king was astonished as well as pleased. "He is indeed very wise," he thought to himself. "I need people like him to work for me." And the king appointed this humble shepherd the governor of a small district. Although he rose up power and dignity, the shepherd remained as humble as ever. People loved and honored him for his wisdom, sympathy, and goodness. He was kind and just to all, one and all. His fame as a fair and wise governor soon spread throughout the country. Now the governors of other provinces grew terribly jealous of him and began to talk to the king against him. He said he is very dishonest and keeps himself a part of the money that he collects as tax from the people. Why did he always carry with him, they added, an iron chest? Perhaps he carried in it the treasure that he had secretly collected. After all, they said mockingly, he was an ordinary shepherd and could behave no better. At first, the king did not pay attention to these reports, but how long could he ignore these governors and their endless stories about the shepherd? One thing was certain, the king discovered. The new governor did carry an iron chest with him all the time. So one day the governor was summoned to the palace. He was riding on his camel, and to everyone's delight, the famous iron chest was there, fastened securely behind him on the camel's back. Now the king was angry. He thundered, "Why do you always carry that iron chest with you? What does it contain?" The governor smiled. He asked his servants to bring in the chest. How eagerly the people standing around waited for the shepherd to be found out. But now great was their astonishment and even of the king himself. When the chest was opened, no gold, no silver, no jewel, but an old blanket
was all that came out.
Holding it up. Now, when the shepherd was saying thank you to the king was very pleased and he said that you are one of the best person I have ever met and I would like to give you a renowned post in my palace. So, he offered him the post of governor. Now, the shepherd became the governor, but the other governors of the provinces were very jealous of this man because he was getting good fame. He was honored. Every time he was honored. Now, that became a part of jealousy for the other governors. Now, what happened? Proudly, the shepherd said, "This, my dear master, is my only treasure. I always carry it with me. But why do you carry such an ordinary blanket with you? Surely you are the governor of a district." The king asked, to which the shepherd replied and with quite dignity, "This blanket is my oldest friend. It will still protect me if at any time your majesty should wish to take away my new cloaks." How pleased the king was and how embarrassed the jealous governors became to hear the wise man's reply. Now they knew that the shepherd was indeed the humblest and the wisest man in the land. The king made him the governor of a much bigger district that very day. Now here is the summary. As I have been explaining, the governors were very jealous and after that, they used to complain everything to the king. They even added that this man, this governor, shepherd, is always carrying an iron chest which is full of all jewels and all money. The king was very surprised. One day he called the shepherd and he asked to open that iron chest. But as soon as he opened, he did not found any money or any jewel in it, but what was there inside was the old blanket. The man replied that this blanket is my oldest friend. The king was very astonished and he gave much higher post to the shepherd. He said that this is my best friend. The king was very pleased when he heard about the story of the blanket and the other governors, the jealous governors, they became very embarrassed. They were ashamed of themselves and the king made him the governor of a bigger district. Now here are the questions which I am sharing. I hope you can find out the answers. Till we meet, thank you and have a wonderful day.